and so horrible. But every Christmas Eve, a swarm of squirrels comes down from the woods and takes over my house. My wife and I have to run for our lives. Well, said the man, I could hide in the slide room and my bear will be happy to lie under the stove over there. You're welcome to take it, the chance, said Halvor. Halvor's wife had laid the table with all sorts of foods, rice pudding, pickled fish, smoking sausages, everything was good to eat, for the trolls were only happy with a great feast. So enough, when the sun had set and the night came down, the trolls from the hills. What a bunch of creatures! Some with tails, some with long noses, all of them making a great noise. The trolls grabbed at the food and the drink and made a great commotion.
Oh my goodness. Those look ugly. Scary.
Suddenly, one of the smaller trolls spied the white bow under the stove. What a pretty pussycat, he shouted. He grabbed a sausage, put it on a fork, and pushed it under the bow's nose. Here you go, pussy. Yum, yum, sang the troll. The great white bow jumped up and roared. The trolls ran out of the house as fast as they could. Each and every one of them rushed off into the night back in the hills. The next afternoon of Christmas Eve, Halvor was cutting wood for the trolls. He was sure they would be coming to his house again. Halvor Igor coming from the wood. I'm here, Halvor answered. Do you still have your big white pussy cat? Halvor thought for a moment. Why, yes, he answered. She's sleeping under the stove. She has seven kittens who are even bigger and fiercer than she. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. To Halvor's great relief, the trolls kept their promise. From that time on, he and his family celebrated Christmas in peace. And for the Great White Bell, the King of Denmark was most pleased with the man's gift. He called the bell Puss.
That and
show me the book.
And that was the story of the cat on the Dovrefell. Mm-hmm. Those are